Welcome. In this video, we will discuss the India-EU relationship. Now, bilateral relationships are very important from UPSC point of view. There has been question in the prelims as well as in the mains. By the end of this video, I will also share the example question which has been asked in the latest years. So, this video, we will discuss about the trade relationship between India and EU. We will also discuss about a very contention point of issue, which is bilateral trade and investment agreement. That is one of the contention issue because of which the India-EU relationship had derailed in the past. And finally, we will talk about the recent development. So let's begin. Let's talk about the India-EU relationship in general. So just to get an idea, we have a relationship as early as 1960s. So India is in fact one of the first countries to establish diplomatic relationship with European Economic Community, which is the community within which there was free trade between these countries. Also, at present, India and the fifth India-EU summit at Hague in 2004, India and EU has become the strategic partnership. Now, you should go and check out which all other countries India have a strategic partner. Does it has it with South Korea or not? That is a question for you. Now let's begin with the trade relationship. As far as trade relationship goes, EU is actually India's largest trading partner grouping. Now when I talk about grouping, it's different because EU is a group of 27 countries as of present, but country-wise, India's largest partner has been USA from two consecutive years now. The second largest partner for India is China, and with China, India has a great trade deficit. And also one thing that you have to remember now, that India is EU's ninth biggest trading partner. So even here, though EU is India's largest trading partner, India is not the largest trading partner for EU. Moving ahead, let's talk about the increase in the trade relationship. So if you see, the trade in services between EU and India has increased rapidly. It was 22.3 billion euro in 2015, but it has now increased to 29.6 billion in 2018. So you can see there has been a rise in the terms of trade, and it has still been growing. Next thing that we have to also remember, that India is also a lucrative spot for EU to give their foreign investment in. So the share in foreign investment inflows to India almost doubled in the last decade, from 8% to 18%. So the last decade, a lot of companies from the EU has came to India and provided the foreign investment inflows. Now let's talk about the bilateral trade and investment agreement. So basically, these agreement will provide certain relaxation in terms of free trade agreement as well as in terms of preferential trade agreement. So what is there? This thing was started way back in 2007, and because of the some issues between the Indian side of negotiation and the European side, there has been not much progress. So even though it's been more than 10 years since we are into this discussion, there has not been any concrete BTIA which has been provided so far. But what we are seeing right now, recently, a couple of days back, there was a virtual EU summit, India-EU summit, which happened, and both of the parties have agreed to take the negotiation further. So they have started talking about the different market access, movement of professional, which were the contention point because of which the talks were stopped at one point of time. Those events will be discussed in detail going forward. So this is the latest development over here, that in the recent virtual summit which happened, India has again started with the high level trade dialogue so that the BTIA could move forward and we can come to an agreement. Another recent developments which were happening during this virtual event was, first of all, yeah, this event happened after a gap of more than 2 years. As I already mentioned, it was because mainly of the way the BTIA is considered from Indian side and from EU side, but the conversation has again started. Another thing that they have talked about is to have a roadmap to 2025. So the 5-year joint action plan on how the relationship will shape has been talked about in the recent summit. Another thing that both India and EU share is their unions of diversity. So like EU, even though it comprises of 27 countries, they share some common values and yet a lot of diversity. India, on the other hand, is though a country, but its various state has different diversity and still it is able to remain in unity. And we share values like democracy, rule of law, and human rights. So Indian constitution is heavily adopted from the Britain laws, House of People. And such values have been inculcated in Indian democracies as well. So going forward, EU and India see a lot of convergence in their values and progress, so that this is the right time for their relationship to solidify. Other development that happened, they have also signed with a civil nuclear operation cooperation agreement, in which they will be working on the nuclear program of civil nature, which includes your energy enrichment and nuclear energy for non-development of nuclear weapons. Also, there has been convergence on the issue of organized crime and terrorism, which India as well as EU consider as a very major problems for the development of the entire world. So the CBI of India and Europol will be working in cognizance to fight against the organized crime and terrorism. Also, there has been a renewal on the science and technology cooperation. So the EU countries have advanced technology and India has the right skills as well as the labor component to actually complement each other and work on that part. Apart from that, there is also a cooperation in terms of environment and climate change. India has already is on a way of proving as a pioneer in terms of the way the climate change action plan has been implemented, especially in terms of renewable energy. And this cooperation will further benefit the movement of climate change mitigation. So now let's, as discussed, we should also see what kind of questions are asked in prelims that comes from this international relationship part of the syllabus. So you see, in 2019, there was a question which specifically asked that with which country India has signed the action plan for prioritization implementation of cooperation areas in nuclear field. So if such kind of question for EU comes, like for which nation India has signed a recent cooperation in civil nuclear program, then if EU is an option, then you know that it's the answer. Similarly, in mains question, there has been question about the bilateral relationship. For example, 2019, they asked about the bilateral relationship of India and Japan, as well as in 2018, they have asked about the bilateral relationship of India and Israel. Maybe this year they could ask about the relationship between EU and India. What are their future perspective? What are their area of convergence? How they can help each other in fighting the terrorism, or in terms of the changing multilateral global environment that we are living in. So when you are reading any topic, try to see the exam point of view as well going forward. I hope you like this video. Please share it among your friends. Thank you.